As we have discussed in the previous sessions and modules regarding the bylaws of the buildings and also the practice sessions of the AutoCAD drawings. This module will be discussing about the line diagrams and bubble diagrams, which are basically connectivity diagrams. As we know, there are three different types of buildings. Preliminary drawings are those drawings which are neat and proportionally dimensioned sketches, not to scale, prepared to serve as a basis for more definitive drawings showing the designer's general intentions. Changes in the layout of the rooms, doors, windows or any part can be done before exerting labor at this stage. And the second one are the diagrams, are either drawn to the scale or not to show axis, circulation, installations and functions of the parts of the building in a simplified way, for which we will be using bubble diagram or line diagram. Line diagram or a bubble diagram is a sketch which may or may not be to the scale, which indicates the arrangement of rooms, toilets, passages, veranda, etc., and also the positions of the doors, windows and other openings. And working drawings are the set of drawings required for the execution of the works. For building construction, this includes foundation plan, plan of different floors, roof plan, longitudinal and cross sections, elevations, architectural and structural details including details of the reinforcement, completely dimensioned and bearing all the indications required for construction. In this working drawings, the site plan and general drainage arrangements can also be provided. In this module, we will study in detail how to draw line and bubble diagrams for public buildings such as school buildings, primary health center, college canteen and office building. Using AutoCAD commands. Different tools of AutoCAD I have been used in order to draw the public buildings, such as drawing tools, lines, circles and polylines are basically used, and among the modifying tools, erase, copy, mirror, offset, move, stretch, lengthen, trim, extend, break has been commonly used, which we have already discussed in the practice sessions of the AutoCAD. Coming to the first type of public building, which is a school building, according to IS 8827-1978, following values may be taken for planning the school depending upon the number of students per class for primary schools, secondary and higher secondary schools, along with the different distribution of areas for classrooms, headmaster's room, general store, water closets, craft room, library and so on, which has been discussed in the next example. Here the problem has been given in which they are asking us to design and draw line diagram and bubble diagram for a school building with the following requirements. The strength of the students has been given as 400. Headmasters, along with that, they require headmaster's room with attached toilet, one number of staff room, one number of office room, one number of library, one number of auditorium and toilets. And also they are asking us to do necessary provisions to be made for corridors. Suitable dimensions may be assumed and indicated. Since the strength of the student is 400, we are taking a standard area of 1.5 meter square per student. Using this calculation, we can calculate the area of each classroom. Area of each classroom, as since the student strength is 400 divided by 8 into 1.5 per student, we are taking classroom as 8. will get 75 meter square. So each classroom we have rounded it off to 80 and taken as 10 meter by 8 meter, that is 80 meter square. Whereas we require 75, on an higher side we are taking 80 meter square. And staff room sizes has been taken as 8 by 8, office as 7 by 5 meter, headmaster's room as 7 by 6 meter, library as 12 by 8 meter. And also a 4 meter wide corridor, which is doubly loaded, takes care of the circulation of the classrooms with separate entry to the playground here. Classroom with a separate entry to the playground, and also the school is basically comprises of two zones. The public area, which includes principal room, staff room, auditorium, and the second one, the main school zone, which includes the classrooms, toilets, staff room and library. The staff room is common to both the zones that binds the two zones together. And the same line diagram can be converted to a bubble diagram, which we have been drawn to scale. I'll just give you a brief explanation on the calculation part, how to calculate the rectangular area to equivalent bubble area. For example, if I take an area of a rectangle as 10 by 8 meter, that was our classroom area. Equivalent bubble area you can convert using the area of the circle is pi d square by 4 is equal to 80. The diameter of the bubble is 10.09 meter. Using this 10.09 meter diameter, you can draw the bubbles. Okay, just to indicate the difference in the sizes between the different rooms using the connectivity. Here the corridor has been indicated with the help of a line which shows connectivity to different rooms. Okay, zone 1 and zone 2. Next problem is a primary health center. As we know, primary health center has some common rooms such as waiting hall, office, doctor's room, ladies doctor room, examination room, technicians, minor operation theatres, dispensary, stores, nurse room and toilets. These are the basic values, what we take, minimum values of the areas. Using this concept, we are trying to design a primary health center with the following requirements. Here the area of different rooms has been already given. Waiting hall is 42 meter square, doctor's room is 12 meter square, lady doctor's room 12, store is 7.5, office is 15 meter square, technician room is 20 meter square, dispensary, nurse room, and they are asking us to give two number of general toilets, one for ladies and one for gents. As per the requirement, we have plotted a line diagram with a common 2 meter wide veranda, which shows the connectivity to different rooms. Here the toilets has been provided in the extreme two ends. One is for access ladies and one for the gents. And from the veranda, the connectivity is given to the waiting hall, where waiting hall connects to the office, doctor's room, ladies doctor's room, dispensary. And other technician room, store and nurse room, the access is provided directly from the veranda. Same can be done and shown through connectivity, bubble connectivity diagram this way, by calculating individual areas and diameters and plotting the different rooms in the form of a circle. The next problem is a canteen building for a first grade college, which has dining hall, a pantry, kitchen, store, preparation, cook's room. And they are asking us to provide facilities for washing and cleaning, entrance hall and separate space for staff in dining hall to a suitable scale. See, as we know from the entrance, access to the dining hall, since there are separate placing for staff and students, you can make a compartment, a division over here for staff and students. And directly this, since the food has to be accessed, the pantry and kitchen can be provided here just to maintain or visualize the hygiene maintained in the kitchen and pantry. Here there will be an open space, and again toilets which has to be accessed both by the student staff and also the workers of the kitchen. And cook room has been provided here along with the store room. Since they had asked separate rooms for preparation, wash and service entry, you can also provide as given like this. The same has been shown in the bubble diagrams by calculating the equivalent circle area. And the fourth one is the office building. Here we are discussing line and bubble diagram of a PWD subdivisional office with the following particulars like entrance hall, administration office, assistant engineer's office with toilets, technician room, draftsman, blueprint and records room, stores and general toilets. Most of us have visited the office buildings, general PWD office building. As we know, it will be in the shape of CL. You can just go for the same designing. There will be a veranda or a corridor connecting different rooms. Since that has two different toilets, you can give the toilets at the end. That asks for an office, a entrance hall, assistant engineer room with the attached toilet over here, technical assistants, draftsman, blueprinting room and store room with the areas which were given in the question. And the same thing can be shown with the help of a bubble diagram to scale by calculating the equivalent circle or a equivalent diameter value. Here again the corridors or veranda have been shown.